so much for coming. We are so happy to be here at such a beautiful theater tonight, on such a beautiful night. This recital, we wanted to showcase music from across Latin America. And so for the first half of our program, we're going to start in the best country in Latin America, Mexico. Yay. So this first piece by Toussaint is very jazzy because Toussaint is a very well-respected jazz composer. And I like to think of him as the George Gershwin of Mexico because of how he combines the jazz rhythms and harmonies with classical elements, which you'll hear in this piece.
Thank you. México, ¿qué tal?
I am really excited to be here. Thank you so much to the Consulate General of Mexico in El Paso, to all the consuls, to Nadia Ornegas, and I'm really, really grateful to be here for you for the second time, as already Mr. San Filippo, who made also this possible. I was here 3 years ago, and I'm really excited to see all of you once more in here, and to be sharing Latin American music this time with Jason Mooney, that we have been working together, as you already heard. And what can I say? I mean, I'm really, really excited. So for the second piece that we will have some Manuel Maria Ponce. I'm a real fan of Manuel Maria Ponce. He was a Mexican composer from the nationalist period, so he was combining some folk music and classical music and made it very popular in Europe and Latin America. So this time we will be sharing with you the Sonata for Cello and Piano that is not very well known. It's a long piece, so please stay there for four movements. We have the very first movement is a combination of some Cuban rhythms because Ponce lived in Cuba for around four or five years, around 1920. And he combined all these Cuban rhythms that he acquired from Havana. So the first movement, it will be a combination of that. The second movement has two sections. The first one is very lyrical, the second, well, the first one is a little bit moving, and then it has that, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the second part, it's a very lyrical melody. Third movement is one of the most beautiful pieces that I have heard from Ponce. And it's a combination of melody between the piano and the cello. And the fourth movement is a surprise. I will not say anything about the fourth movement because I want you to enjoy it. Thank you so much. We'll be right back with you.
Thank you.
Brazilian music, he was there, and with American composer Aaron Copland. This piece, Desafio, means challenge. So the piece opens with a fiery solo for the cello, and then the second section, that's the challenge. So there's a very fiery dialogue between the cello and the piano.
Thank you.
So this first tango is by Jose Braganto. And Jose Braganto was the cellist in Astor Piazzolla's orchestra, the principal cellist. And he was very close with Piazzolla, and he did a lot of work archiving his music after he died. Braganto died actually just last year at the age of 102. So this tango has everything you could possibly want in a tango for cello and piano.
Thank you.
said, well, how about if we commission a piece? And I said, sure, why not, right? So we're very excited to share with you this work by Sonia Posetti. She's an Argentinian composer. She's very young, probably in her like mid-30s or so. And this project started because we played as a trio. We had a violin, cello, and piano. Now the violinist is not with us anymore, right? But, well, no, I mean, no, but she got pregnant, basically, and then she went out. Thank you, Jason. And we were playing this trio that had three sections by Sonia Posetti. And we absolutely love this piece. We said, well, how about, I mean, since we don't have too many tangos for cello and piano in this case, said, how about if we commission this piece? So we did a Kickstarter project, and we raised money for that. We really want to thank all the sponsors that we that they believed in this project, and they made it happen. And today it's going to be the first time that we're going to play this piece. The name is Petals by Sonia Posetti. And I really want to thank once more the Consulate General of Mexico in El Paso. I want to thank Marcela Gonzalez for all her help. I want to also thank the Consul Juan Acereto because they believed in this project too. And that's why the name is also Tango for Piano. I don't know, Jason, you want to add anything else about the piece? Well, then, let's enjoy Petals. Yay!
Thank you.
And finally we have another one, so that's great. Now we move on to into our last piece. And I really want to thank so much all of you for being here, for supporting us tonight, for supporting the consulate, and hopefully you will stay tuned and also attend the other activities of the consulate, that they have too many activities, and all of them, they are really interesting and different ones. So our Grand Tango, it's one of my favorite pieces. And that's why we put it at the end, right? And it's a very flashy piece, let's say. It's like kind of, you know that we had the Desafío before by Nobre, and this one is kind of like, not a fight, but let's say an argument between the cello and piano. And it has three different sections as well. The first one is fast, the second one is very lyrical, and the third one is really hard. But we really enjoy playing this piece, and I think Astor Piazzolla is probably the most recognized composer for tangos, and probably you have heard Liber Tango, probably you have heard Grand Tango as well, so Milonga de un Ángel, probably those names are familiar to all of you. So we hope you like this last piece. Thank you so much for being here, really. We're really excited to be playing for you our last piece. Thank you. Thank you.